Welcome to Psych IRL. My name is Donna. Today I'm going to be explaining the experimental method to you through a study Facebook might be doing to you right now. The experimental design is the only design that allows you to identify cause and effect relationships. Let's look at the famous controversial Facebook study as an example. Step one of the experimental design is to ask a question. In this case, can someone's emotions be affected by what their friends post on social media? So like, I can be happy 1 minute, I log onto Facebook, see my friends posting depressing stuff, and then all of a sudden, I start posting depressing stuff. Step two, do background research. Previous research has shown this emotional contagion in face-to-face interactions. Step three, formulate a hypothesis. Predict what will happen based on the research you've found. I think if my friends post more sad things, then I will be sad. Step four, experiment. Figure out your independent variable. This is the variable you will manipulate. In this case, it will be emotional content expressed on Facebook newsfeed. Next, figure out your dependent variable, or what you will measure. In this case, it will be emotionality expressed in a person's own status update. Who your experiment will affect refers to the population. In this case, it's Facebook users. We then take a sample of the population and randomly assign them into two groups, the control group or the experimental group. The experimental group will have the independent variable manipulated. Participants in this group will either have positive statuses shown to them or more negative statuses shown to them. This is the defining characteristic of what makes this an experimental design. They're able to randomly assign participants to either condition. If the experiment asked, are males more aggressive than females after playing violent video games? Then the independent variable would be males and females. But since you can't assign people to gender, you're a male. You're a female, you're a male, you're a female. This wouldn't be an experimental design. The control group will be used as a comparison to the experimental group. They will have the same number of positive and negative statuses shown to them. Step five, analyze the data and make conclusions. So people who had positive content reduced in their newsfeed, a larger of their words in their own status updates were negative, and a smaller percentage of their words were positive. When the negativity was reduced, the opposite pattern occurred. So how did Facebook get away with this, you ask? Well, you know that thing where you accept the terms in use when you first sign up? Yep, that pretty much gives them clearance to experiment on you and other stuff. So this is just a brief overview of the Facebook study. If you want to read more about it, check out the article in the description below. I've also linked more articles about the experimental design below if you're still confused. I will see you next time.
Psychology isn't a science.
Yes, psychology is a science. We use the scientific method.
Number four. Oh, you're like Dr. Phil.